This week, our team of monster builders get to test their tropical chops.
Good, huh?
As they attempt to transform this quaint little starter home into a Polynesian paradise. The homeowners have agreed to hand over their keys to the master of monster makeovers, Steve Watson.
It's Monster House, baby.
An average Joe with a passion for bigger, badder, and bolder. Steve is on a mission to blast the roof off of remodeling.
Welcome to Monster House.
Our house was plain and simple. It was safe and normal. It was nice and sweet. But we all agreed we could use a change. And then something happened that was very strange. Cause a van showed up, all our stuff went flying. And my mom was crying till the job was done. Now it's a monster house. It's a monster house. It's a monster house. And we all just love it. It's a monster house.
Tyler and Emily, a couple of Southern California lovebirds who've recently staked their claim to the American dream.
And I've been saving up for a while trying to get our life started and finally bought a home.
But the grandma decor their new home came with isn't exactly their style.
We live like an old married couple.
The dogs have to go.
So they asked Steve to turn it into an over-the-top tropical getaway.
I've traveled all over the world. I've seen all kinds of places, and my favorite areas are always like the tropical belt. So we really want to have our home feel like a vacation.
They have agreed to leave all design and construction decisions in the hands of Steve and his team. All they'll know is what they can see from the motorhome parked out front. But before the games begin, they'll need a plan. Steve summons his design team to help figure out how to turn Granny's cottage into a Hawaiian hideaway. Architect Todd Erlinson, illustrator Craig Rizzo, and Hollywood production designer Roy Reed take on this Micronesian makeover.
Tyler and Emily want a tropical theme, but I'm thinking tropical to the extreme, a permanent honeymoon. One image that I'm having is just a huge tiki god head, just something massive, the centerpiece.
We can just build it right into the existing wall here, and that's about where the mouth would be anywhere, where the fireplace is.
I want it to breathe fire.
In the tropics, it rains every day. How can we get rain and moisture into the house?
To make it feel like you're more outside, if you can bring the outside inside.
This house has a handicapped bathroom, which basically is a fully enclosed room that's all tile with a drain in the floor.
It's like a wet room.
Yeah, it's a wet room.
They do a lot of these multi-head showers now, so maybe you could get it to work out where you could get three or four heads spraying from different directions.
How cool would it be if these guys could actually sit and have dinner and grill their food at the exact same time?
Oh, that's like Benny.
Yeah, I'm thinking just a big, like massive table.
Yeah.
With a grill in the middle. That's a perfect party right there. That's perfect.
It's gonna be a tropical house. You gotta do some work on
it. You gotta sell it.
And you gotta connect this great room here with this potentially great out.
Well, let's get rid of the concrete.
Yes.
The pool is just a regular blue bottom pool. I want to feel like I'm in paradise, no cell phones, you know? If it was like black and looked like a lagoon, I think it would look great.
How do they?
If they could have a rainstorm whenever they wanted it.
Like a supercharged monster visiting system.
Now you're talking. Now you're talking some Monster House stuff.
We can put some jets up here to blow water in front of the fan so that when the fan goes on, it kicks the water.
Exactly.
Here's the plan. The living room fireplace will be turned into a flame-breathing tiki god. The bathroom will feature a rock-covered rainforest shower. A kitchen wall gets knocked out for a pass-through bar and built-in aquarium. The dining room will get a bamboo table with a built-in hibachi grill. The backyard will be turned into Tahiti.
This is going to be one of the coolest houses ever. Good job. Good work.
Now, it's all in the hands of this week's construction crew. Our tropical transformation team makes its way toward Tyler and Emily's love nest. Thomas Junge, a German jack of all trades. Michael Fox, architect and builder. Scott Sellers, kitchen customizer. Kim Larson, scenic artist, she devil. And production designer Roy Reed makes the leap from design team to build crew. They'll have to complete the entire remodel in only 5 days. If successful, they'll each receive tools worth over $3,000. It's 7 a.m. Tyler and Emily hand the keys over to our monster builders.
Here are the keys.
As our couple makes their way to the motorhome, 12 tons of concrete barrel into their driveway.
Oh, man. What's he gonna do, fill in the pool? What does he need that much cement for?
All right, you guys ready to get to work?
You know it.
Yeah. It's your idea.
Is Tyler already feeling remodeler's remorse?
It's your idea.
We got a big job this week.
Inside, Skipper Steve lays out the plan.
Challenge. It's going to be a lot of fun. We have Emily and Tyler. They're getting married. We're going to give them a tropical theme paradise honeymoon home. And when I say tropical theme, I'm not talking just wallpaper with, you know, pineapples and bananas and coconuts. This is Castaway times 10. This table here is going to be a bamboo table with a hibachi grill in the middle. We're going to have rock walls. Right here in this opening, we're going to have a terrarium. All right, the kitchen, all of this, gone. We're gonna cut it out. We're gonna extend this top all the way into the living room so they can have a bar top in the living room. Right here, we're gonna have an aquarium. All this is gonna be taken out. This is gonna scare the hell out of people. Bam, tiki god, huge tiki god. I want this thing spitting flames. I want rocks inside here, maybe a little seat of some kind over here, like just made out of the stone and the rock. I want shower heads everywhere so that you stand there and you're just getting beat with warm water. And outside. We're gonna drain the pool, scrape it, paint the pool bottom black, give it that lagoon feel. The concrete all around the pool, every bit of it's gonna go. We're also gonna crash a boat. And I want them to feel like they're stranded on a deserted island every time they're in their house. Just, I want a thunderstorm. I want these guys to be able to flip a switch and have just as much rain as they would have in the middle of a monsoon. I understand that these people live here. Treat it like it's your own house. But get it done by Friday at midnight.
The team's reaction to Steve Watson's battle plan is a mixture of shock and disbelief. Roy worries if this monster is too big to tackle.
From where we're sitting, it looks completely undoable.
The team hunkers down to form a plan of attack.
Any electrical, any plumbing, demo, framing, structural stuff, I can do all that. You guys can come in right behind me and do more of the design type stuff.
I've built the lunar landscape of the moon out of foam before, so I'm pretty comfortable with rocks and foam and framing and chicken wiring. And
I could be helpful with that.
Yeah, I know you've done it too.
The plan calls for a small mountain of volcanic rocks. These rocks will be constructed of fire-retardant foam sprayed onto mesh and chicken wire and held up by a wooden frame. Already, there's a crunch. The foam must be blown by Tuesday at noon if it's going to be carved and painted by Friday's deadline. That makes building the support frame priority one. But they can't even do that until they get some lumber.
I would suggest that it get done before the end of the day, at least 95% of it.
While Kim calls in an order to the lumber yard, the boys get busy.
It's time to break stuff.
There's no one in the camper, so I'm just gonna give them their present. That's pretty.
Tiki heads, it's just a shave-in block.
Right, and then
there.
We put,
you know.
While waiting for the wood, Kim and Roy pick out tiki heads.
That's classic. I'm trying to find a big tiki head that's gonna look great on that fireplace. This guy.
Oh, I like his mouth.
If we could just drop the bottom, just alter this face a little bit.
Beautiful.
That's classic, too.
Yeah, that's a classic
right
shape.
There. Boom, on top of that. That's funky. That'll look great.
Trying to map out the features so when we frame it, we know where to lay in everything. Doesn't look like anything now, but it'll be menacing. We don't want it to look like a clown. We want it to look scary.
In the kitchen, Scott and Michael pound down a wall to make room for the pass-through bar and built-in aquarium. While the swimming pool quietly drains into the street, a battle is brewing inside over how to get the tiki god to breathe fire.
Were you looking for the fire to pop?
The problem is that the existing gas line lacks the pressure to belch out a ball of fire.
Butane, if you feel more comfortable with that.
You can't just add extra gas to an existing fire without possibly exploding.
If you already have an existing gas line in the fireplace, then, and it hasn't blown up, then why can't you have another gas line that just periodically pumps more gas into the fire?
You're not gonna have the pressure. Standard gas line pressure is gonna be maximum 15 PSI.
If we wanted to do it for the camera.
I'm not interested in doing anything for the camera. I don't even wanna hear that again. That is not the purpose of this conversation or what we're doing in this house is not for the camera. We're doing something cool for the family. Figure it out, guys, figure it out. I mean, make that, I wanna see those flames move one way or the other. Put you right there with a can of hairspray.
Outside, a load of lumber, courtesy of stock building supply, lands on the lawn. Finally, Michael hits on a solution.
So why can't we just let a certain amount of, like, propane if we have it?
His idea? Like, add a propane tank to fuel the extra blast of fire.
Light the match, it goes exactly what we want. Like a grill, you can turn it on and turn it off, and the gas is there in the little coil.
Tyler and Emily return home from work, and it looks like a tsunami has hit their front yard.
That looks like my dresser.
I hate that.
Why does that follow us everywhere?
Inside, the crew has finally started framing out the tiki god. Scott and Thomas power through the 2x4s. Kim and Roy cut into some chicken wire. But it's getting late, and the team is getting tired.
I'd rather not stay here till friggin' 11 o'clock tonight if we can't help it. So we're fresh tomorrow now that we know what's going on, and from like tomorrow on out, case.
Monday. With only half the framing done, they decide to call it quits. It's a decision that could come back to haunt them. Tuesday begins with a morning powwow. Last night's decision to knock off early is already looking like a mistake.
We have less than 5 hours to get all this stuff framed for the rocks and the foam, and it has to be done by noon. And he's not gonna wait. He's gonna come in, do it, and then leave.
I'm ready to go to work.
All right.
All right.
As the deadline looms, the team scrambles to make up for lost time.
Yeah, I'll go.
Kim digs in, and so does the chicken wire.
Me and the chicken wire had a little, we had it out.
Okay, Kim, but what's up with the horns?
Well, I came up with this hairstyle about 10 years ago. It's fun. I'm a little angel. I gotta do something to protect myself.
I am every inch a lady.
Every inch a lady in pink nails and work boots.
Steve is starting to panic.
Are you guys gonna make it in? What's going on?
Are we gonna make it?
Yeah, by noon, because he's gonna come in here blasting and then leave.
Well, I would tell him to bring a thermos or something cool to drink while he's waiting.
Come on now, Roy, we can do it. Don't say that.
If it's not done by noon, then there's gonna be some major problems, so just keep that in mind.
We got ya. There's a little tension building around here. There's some testosterone flowing.
Steve's frustrated because he wanted this done last night. What can we do? You know, we can't just whip it up in 15 minutes, so.
It's not my fault that they went home early last night. They should have worked last night and gotten this stuff done and got ready for the foam. Then today they could be working on new projects. But no, so he wants to be a smartass and run his mouth, that's fine.
They're both gonna just be fine. Because they're guys and they'll just pretend it didn't happen. If they were women, they'd be fighting for the rest of the week.
In the bathroom, Michael has just started framing the rocks for the rainforest shower.
I'm gonna stack 2x4s on top of these to screw them in so we can have a little bit of depth and we can mold the chicken wire in, you know, around these things. Just gonna pop out a few of those tiles and make an inset box for shampoo.
To make matters worse, the tiki god needs a complex lighting system controlled by a motion detector that has to be wired and working before the foam covers it up.
I'm hooking up the power that'll go to this right now.
Okay, go.
We're gonna be hooked up here in about 5 minutes with a switch and all our receptacles to test them, and if they work, those guys can go to town on getting this finished wired up for the phone. Quite a bit of electrical in here.
Okay.
All right.
Okay.
Should be 2 breakers.
Gotta see if something finally works.
Do the honors, boss.
Ah! Hold on, one more connection right here.
Sorry, guys. All right, Steve, try the switch again.
Is this thing gonna work now?
We're good to go, I hope so. Uh-oh, we got problems.
We're losing power to one of our outlets, which is making it lose power to the lights.
Thomas, check that receptacle.
Which we have to have work in before noon when they spray the foam for the big tiki face.
So it's not getting any power at all?
Nope.
Check some of these breakers. You know what? Maybe that was on a light switch, guys. That could be on an independent light switch.
See, all this stuff was hooked up, and I plugged an extension cord into it to check all of this, and it works fine. So I think...
There it is! Yay!
An hour's been wasted, and Roy finally gets to start tacking up the chicken wire.
So what do you think? What's the time frame on this thing?
I'll let you know.
Steve thinks we're gonna be able to get this foam ready in 45 minutes. Steve's a dreamer.
This is real important to get the angle of the mouth just right. It's the difference between making it look really good and making it look kind of thrown together and crappy. Because this is the most important part of the whole living room, and it's the biggest thing, and it's gonna require the most sculpting and detail. And it seems like it's the last thing we were able to get to just because of all the electronics and mechanics and framing involved.
Just to keep things interesting, the pool crew shows up.
How loud's it gonna get?
Pretty loud.
We're gonna piss off all the neighbors today.
To turn the pool into a tropical lagoon, the concrete liner has to be removed and replaced with a black one. Woo. Scott grabs a jackhammer and shows off his resurfaced skin.
I started getting tattooed when I was 15. And covered from head to toe now. Tattoos are really addicting, you know. As soon as you get a few of them, a lot of people just can't stop.
Not enough time. Not enough time.
The team makes a mad dash for the finish line. But time has run out.
The foam guy's here. I'm a little stressed out. I'm just gonna direct him into the rooms that are ready for him, and we will get everybody together in the sections that aren't finished and do what we can.
First up, the rocks for the rainforest shower.
That's it right there.
Yep.
In the living room, with just seconds to spare, Roy lays the last of the chicken wire. Right before their eyes, a tiki god is born.
Oh, yeah.
Painting the check.
Kickoff
singles.
Tiki god.
That is bitchin'.
That's so bitchin'.
Get some.
Maybe if these people don't like this house, maybe I'll buy it from them.
They're gonna freak.
But there's no rest for the weary. Out front, Steve shows up with a shipwreck.
Somebody needed a boat.
This is so great.
But sailing it into the backyard isn't going to be easy.
We were excited when we saw it, but we gotta figure out how to get a 32-foot boat through a 4-foot-wide gate.
The team dry docks the sailboat for the time being and dives into the dining room.
There's other things on the priority list right now, but I can't stand these ducks, and I'm getting rid of them now because they're so cute. I hate them.
Get rid of these ducks.
We'll frame that table up. We'll frame the shaft. We'll get the hood.
Out back, Scott lays out a plan for the hibachi dining table.
We're going to have to do a roof penetration. Well, let's go get 30 10-foot 2x4s. And we'll get the ducting and we'll get the hood.
Okay.
Now that the wall between the dining room and the kitchen is gone, Roy can't wait to shop for an aquarium.
30x12x24 high. That is an aquarium of beauty.
28 wide by 9.5 deep.
by high.
I'd pay that price gladly to get that thing made. Monster House. All right, thanks, buddy. Bye.
As Tuesday winds down, Emily wanders home, sipping a shaker full of second thoughts.
I have a scary feeling today coming home. I don't know why.
Did you really?
Yeah, I really do.
Nothing really went down today too much.
Okay. Oh, the ducks are gone. Tyler will be really happy about this. That's good.
Inside, Roy and Kim try to get their god from friendly to ferocious.
What's the number one goal right now? What's the
target? Oh, he looks a little surprised.
Yeah, I don't know if I like that.
We're trying to get a more distinct look going on, a really sharp, sharp look going on there, so he looks a little more terrifying. You know, right now he looks a little drippy. We're going to really sharpen him up and get him a little meaner.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Is he getting pissed?
He's getting pissed.
But all this work is getting under their skin.
I've got scratches and scrapes and foam up my nose.
I've got it more places than up my nose.
I'm getting a crush on her.
By day's end, there's a few signs of progress. The pool has been stripped. The shower's sporting boulders. And Easter Island has arrived in the living room.
Ooh, diggy god.
But it's 2 days down and not a single project close to completion. Wednesday begins in a haze in more ways than one.
Lord, I just need something to test
this
thing.
Well, you're looking for a sentence.
That's all I care about right now.
If I cut out here, can you?
Steve's chomping at the bit to get a fog machine into the tiki god.
There we go.
Oh, you ready to test this thing?
There's an always hot outlet over here. We just gotta uncover it. Which is what I said.
It's not even 8 a.m., and already the boys are bickering.
I just need an extension cord.
Well, all right, I know you're obsessed with having smoke fill up the fireplace, but maybe we want to wait until we're done with the wiring to test. We know the smoke will come out, and we know it will go where we want it to go.
If they were women, they'd be fighting for the rest of the week.
Up in
here
there,
it comes.
To light.
Yeah, we'll get some kind of.
That's perfect. That'll be great. That'll scare the kids.
In the bathroom, Scott has started installing 7 shower heads.
I'm doing a shower head here, here, and here.
Oh, they're not going to be even.
No, they want them nice. Funky and bury them.
Yeah, nice.
Running copper for our shower head, and then run hot and cool.
This tropical downpour will be fed by a tangle of copper pipes, all of which need to be cut and soldered.
There you go.
So what are they gonna think if they ever have to take this wall down and see what you're doing to it?
They're gonna wonder who put the octopus in their wall.
It's early afternoon. Our bickering builders test their teamwork skills by balancing a big box of glass. In the bathroom, Scott gets a little too trigger happy with a nail gun.
I was nailing a block in the bathroom, shot a 16-penny, 3 1/4-inch long nail through my finger, the gun double shot on me. It's no big deal. Welcome to Monster House.
He pulls out the Monster First Aid Kit.
Ready, guys? Ah, mother.
We have some peroxide here.
Luckily, it went right through the top of the bone.
Your tools are your friend, but you gotta watch out for them because they'll bite you.
What's everyone scared now?
Mid-afternoon, Michael has decided to add a terrarium wall to the entrance.
Wow, that's a narrow terrarium, huh?
We can sand it down.
A narrow terrarium?
Roy has his doubts. The wall is less than 5 inches wide.
Mm-hmm. Six, it's 5.5 inches wide. What are we gonna put in it?
Cockroaches. We're gonna need to put some kind of. We can put ants too.
That's this torture for a lizard.
Michael forges on, figuring it's not his job to make either Roy or the lizards happy. The sun is set, and the weary team is running on fumes.
I want to get the hell out of here. I'm tired. It was a rough day.
I am burned out on foam. I am emotionally foamed out.
I think if you guys do want to call it a night, that it would be a good way to cap off the night would be to
try the shower.
Get that water running.
Getting ready to water test our monkey monstrosity of pipe. This is the only time it'll ever have to fill up because it'll always stay full.
Yeah. All they get is a steady drizzle. There's not enough pressure to power the 7 shower heads.
That actually looks pretty cool, though. It's just kind of like a little rain.
It's like a rain, man.
Yeah. Like a little rain curtain.
I think it's really hot.
You know what we got to do? We'll just get a different shower head for that. I'll get one of these to put there, and we'll be rocking.
It's another step forward and another build day down the drain.
I'm thinking about floors.
Thursday morning, just 2 days left and no lack of jobs that still need to get done, including a beach sailboat.
There's still this big monster down the street that you guys don't seem to want to talk about it.
All due respect, guys, Steve, we really need to wrap this up and get and hit the ground. We all know that we have way too much to do.
Right.
We could move
and I'm still, but I'm still talking. I'm still telling you guys what needs to be done. And I will let you know when this meeting's over. All right, how about that?
Okay.
Okay. I want to know what's going on with this boat before we go to lunch today.
Hi.
Thomas and Scott start in the dining room building a vent hood for the hibachi table. Despite the 16-penny hole in his finger, Scott shows no signs of slowing.
This morning it started throbbing like a bass drum, but it's not bugging me.
Got our electrical hooked up. Exhaust fan's working. We're gonna get some light bulbs and test it out. Burnout, we can always try another one. Sweet.
But it's not sweet for Steve.
We're gonna have to raise that hood. That's gotta come up. And then like it's gonna come up. Basically, this has gotta be raised about right there.
He's right. The sketch clearly shows ample headroom for the diners.
There goes 2 hours down the. There's no easy way of doing it. Rip the whole thing down and redo it.
Can we not just take this down and just cut that and then
can't do it. There's too much crap on there already. And I'm gonna cut all these studs off right here. We'll cut all these the same, but we'll burn 1.5 inches and we're gonna have to put another plate here and raise it up. Otherwise, we gotta throw this whole thing in the trash and start over. You know, I ran the height by everyone and everything was happy, you know? And now it's all up.
Steve.
We got so much stuff to do and so little time to do it, and having to deal with crap like this is killing us.
Scott puts his fingers on yet another problem.
Power's on. It's just when you grab the wires and you think the power's off and it's not and it lights you up, it's not that it hurts, it surprises you.
A few quick cuts bring the hibachi hood down to size.
We said this was gonna take an hour to do this, but we did it in like 15 minutes because we're pissed. We had to move this up 11 inches. I don't really give a damn anymore, it's finished. All right, lights.
Here.
Camera, power. Oh yeah, there we go.
They make up for lost time and dive right into the tabletop.
We're not gonna cut the center out.
Yeah, we're gonna go one.
In the living room, Kim and Roy do a quick nip and tuck on the tiki god's grimace.
He's got one cheekbone, but he doesn't have two. This whole piece, you just reverse it and slap it on there. I think that we need a little more symmetry than we've got going on here.
Out in front, three generations of blondes show up.
This is my crazy mom.
Hi, guys. I live in Mammoth,
that's her.
California.
And this is my grandma.
And I'm Graham.
We had to come see what you guys are doing to my baby girl's house.
I'm wondering where all the cement came from.
Here. And this must be the monster evil woman.
Hi, nice to meet you. My name's Kim.
Kim.
We're having a great time. I haven't had this much fun in a long time.
Really? So we're ready for the open house party.
Yeah.
You guys are going to be here?
I hope so. I definitely want to be here when the walkthrough happens.
As Emily hustles the moms off to lunch, Steve scrambles for the sailboat.
Wondering, because a big 20-foot sailboat right in front of their house, I think, would give away the surprise.
All right.
The only way they're going to get this behemoth in the backyard is to bisect it.
Okay, block.
Slap a block underneath it.
Good job, guys.
you got this. Lower that front, okay. Lower the nose. We're gonna cut this thing right down the center.
Has anybody measured the pool and how much room we actually have for this thing?
Roy figures a little measuring is called for.
Just get that lead out and just cut it.
The plan is to cut this boat in half. That is the only plan that we have, is to get this boat cut in half. That is...
Yeah. I agree with Steve. Cut first, ask questions later.
Yeah, we'll deal with it later. We'll just get it in pieces.
One more problem. The hull they're about to cut into is made of fiberglass.
Anyone knows fiberglass makes you itchy. Once it gets on your skin, man, it'll drive you crazy.
A quick coin toss lands this nasty job in the lap of Scott and Thomas.
We use the saws off of the others.
Being tired and itchy, I don't think it's a good combination here.
Everything went real smooth. It only took us about 15, 20 minutes to cut in half. I thought it was gonna take us like an hour or two.
So masculine.
That was the biggest project of the week, and it took all of 3 minutes.
You guys just kicked.
Oh, good job. It's cool. We're gonna put this thing in the backyard. Now we just gotta figure out how we're gonna get it back there.
Before moving the boat, they first wanna make some headway in the backyard. The pool has been black coated and it's already refilling, but the tiki hut isn't even started.
Four more.
Right now we're getting ready to build our little tiki hut back here. It's just gonna be a little 8x8 hut. We're gonna have one step up into it, 2x6 floor joists with 2x4s flat for the flooring. So we could probably build this thing, depending on the roof design, in probably 4 hours.
Unstoppable Scott fires away on the nail gun. Out front, a green giant dumps a few tons of dirt in the driveway. Just as our three blondes make an unexpected return.
Now what's with all the dirt?
In the living room, the crew is still struggling to get the tiki god to breathe fire.
This is the gas right here. This is
a bubble.
A flame that's gonna burst out of the tiki's head in the fireplace and give like a just quick burst.
Michael tests out his propane idea.
We got like the tank and these switches from Holiday RV, and it's just an electronic switch for the gas valve.
Going on.
Yeah.
Stop. Very cool.
With the sun going down, Scott decides to hold off framing the tiki hut until tomorrow.
I don't really want to be up there framing the roof after dark.
A true team player, he climbs under the house to help run the gas line.
I'm going underneath the house in the crawl space to locate the gas line for the fireplace.
But the rest of the team is missing in action.
Mike! I'm lying down here and he leaves. Mike! Mike!
Mike!
The boys bail on Scott and call it a night.
Today was crazy, tomorrow's gonna be twice as bad.
Only our horn set builder is still going strong.
We're getting ready to paint. I'm just doing a little prep work on the windows here, and we're gonna get some color in here and start making this look like real rock. I'm stoked. I'm excited. It's late, punchy, and we're gonna kick it out.
People like this.
We're gonna start in this room with a sort of a lava rock, so it's got a deep red tone to it, earthy red lava rock look. We'll let this peek through a glaze, tones, shadows. We'll spray on a few different kinds.
She's going to spend the night with her tiki god. It's Friday, crunch day. The team arrives early to find a Technicolor transformation.
I finished the tiki room about midnight and then busted out the bathroom about 5 this morning. Went, took a nap in the car, and I came back to start for another day. That today is gonna be a giddy, freaky day where I'll probably just be bouncing off the walls.
Despite this progress, not a single area of the house is completely finished.
The outside, we haven't even tackled yet, except for the cabana, we have the frame up. Still have to get the boat back there. We still have to finish this bathroom. Hopefully we can get this place cleaned up by midnight and get out of here.
Michael starts off the day by adding nostrils to the Tiki Head's fog machine.
And we are in some business.
But when Steve tries to put it back, it won't fit.
Is it gonna fit in there, Steve?
Nope.
And for some reason, Roy finds that funny.
It's more fun this way.
Yeah.
It's better TV.
It's not about television, it's about getting the work done right.
Certain people don't understand that.
Work's done right. See, that's why I can't get the thing. You know what?
As far as your perfect TV thing, arguing with your host will never make it on the air, so.
Arguing with your host will never make it on the air.
Oh, I know.
If they were women, they'd be fighting for the rest of the week.
I'm trying to get this fog machine into this tiki head, and the other day it fit just fine. 2 or 3 times it took it in and out, in and out. Now, mysteriously, it won't fit.
I don't know why it's not going in when it went in for the last 2 days.
Just in day 5 drama, that's all.
In the bathroom, Scott's using industrial hand dryers to create a warm tropical breeze for the rainforest shower.
They're just dryers like you'd see on the wall at a restaurant or something to dry your hands, and we're gonna wire them up.
Thank you.
So they're running constant off a switch. I'm gonna try to fit through that small hole that we cut in the wall to wire up our blowers where the fart fan is.
I don't even know if I'm gonna fit in here, bro.
Just pulled out the fart fan. I don't have much room to work up here. If I'm not underneath the house crawling on my belly in the dirt, I'm up in the attic like a pretzel. That was fun.
Oh. Monster House Man of the Week, Scott Sellers. He's been shot, speared with a nail gun, and left for dead under the house. Is there anything this guy can't handle?
Oh, there goes my glasses. Sweet. Now I get to have funky glasses for the rest of the day.
Who was in charge of this terrarium? I'm gonna know exactly what their plan was.
By the front entry, Steve decides that the terrarium needs some doors.
If you got a couple small doors, I mean, every little aquarium has a small door.
Yeah. The first thing you see when you walk in the door, that's going to be really ugly. I'm a designer, from a visual point of view. If you f*** it up, we got to buy another sheet of plexi.
Yeah.
They bring me on as a designer for the design aspect of it, and they completely ignore every design aspect I bring forward. It's not going to look professional, no matter how carefully we do it. It's gonna look like we just threw some doors in plexi, and it's the first thing you see when you come in the house is a homemade piece of plexi with doors in it. It's just gonna look like crap.
For once, they decide to let Roy do it his way.
I just decided to bring it out a little bit, just to give it a little bit of openness. So instead of just being a straight sealed box, we're gonna have a little bit of a flare up to the ceiling. Cover it with a netting. And you'll walk in, it'll just be very dramatic. Very, very excited about this now. If you want to do this.
Yeah.
Roy confers with Thomas on a design for the lid.
I can do it here.
In place of doors, it will have an overlapping lid, so creatures can get in, but not out.
It's all voice.
From here, but I
do. Otherwise, it's she now.
Thomas, that is
beautiful. I'm psyched. I want to paint it and lay that plexi in.
A few wood screws, and something is finally built.
Thanks, Steve.
Pick up the boat.
It's mid-afternoon. Time for a showdown with the sailboat.
Great. Let's do it.
Scott pulls out his custom sailboat moving device.
Cool. Okay.
Perfect.
Damn, I'm a genius.
With only millimeters to spare, they manage to squeeze it through.
Come clockwise, guys. Hit.
Got our butts scraped, but I feel good. I feel like a man. Finally.
I'm just glad to have them back here, both pieces. Now I think we actually have a pretty good chance of making this thing and getting it done by midnight.
In the shower, Scott's ready to wire the blowers.
Surgery complete. We're out of the woods. One circuit there, one circuit here, neutral ground. Up in the inaccessible crawl space. And it's hard as hell up here. Oh. I'd rather cut a boat in half outside and carry it in the backyard than work in the attic. All right, this is starting to piss me off. Now we'll hook up our blowers. And in a little while, we'll have some snake things blowing hot air out of the lid.
Oh, yeah.
Good.
Nice.
And these need to be cut and adjusted, and that thing's got to get hooked up, but...
Check one rainforest shower off the to-do list. But as Friday wears down, there's a major project that hasn't even been started, the backyard monsoon.
All right, what we're gonna do is we've got this fan that's sitting right over there. We're gonna get the fan up on the roof. It weighs 300 pounds. All of us will be lifting that thing up.
You guys ready?
Ready?
The monsoon will be powered by a high-velocity industrial fan.
The effect we're looking for is to blow the wind real hard. All the water in the pool, we want it to ripple up and down and mist and kind of like a hurricane deal. Should be pretty cool. One of the things I've been looking forward to seeing how it happens when we turn it on.
We've got a good 6 hours, and if we just keep moving at this pace, we haven't stopped moving all day.
I had no idea that we only had 6 hours left. If anyone could do it, this team could do it. I really have faith in those boys.
As darkness falls, the tension mounts. If any one project is left undone, the team will go home empty-handed. Roy builds rain bars out of copper pipes.
Every 6 inches, we got to drill a little 3/16 inch hole. So when the water pumps through, it's going to spray out, not like sort of a crosswind of mist and a rain. It'll be really cool.
A festival of spraying waters when it's ignited, when it's turned on. It's going to be awesome.
Thank God it's Friday.
10 p.m., typhoon time. With less than 2 hours left, the team tears into the tiki hut.
We're gonna be off to framing up the tiki hut. We got the roof system to do and a few other little things, and hopefully we can show you that in a couple hours.
We're just kicking. This thing is framed up and ready to go. The rest of it's just, you know, boxing that thing in and decorating and putting the roof on.
Hey, what's up, sexy?
Good, huh? Yeah, this is the stuff that goes up on the roof.
As the last hours tick away, the team makes a mad dash for the finish line. p.m. Steve is still trying to get his deity to breathe fire.
I've been working on this tiki god all night long to get it to finally breathe fire. And been working on the propane system all day.
That is the last thing.
If I can just get this stupid tiki god to blow some fire, we're finished.
We got it. Everyone, breathe. Okay. Everybody, I said be still. Okay, that sucked. It's doing this to piss me off.
Finally just got back there and tweaked around with the valve a little bit to get a little more propane going through there.
Guys, what do you think? We can clean this place up and get it ready.
Saturday, the Monster Finishing Crew does some last-minute touch-ups with donations from Lumber Liquidators and Benson's Tropical Sea Imports. Finally, it's time for Tyler and Emily.
We've got about a minute to go. I'm more anxious than I think I've ever been in my life right now to get in that house and see what's going on.
After five sleepless nights, Tyler and Emily are ready to meet their monster.
Oh my God.
Welcome to your monster house.
Oh my God. Is that like a Korean barbecue?
It's your new dining room.
Your new styling tiki bar grill.
Oh my gosh.
We've got a stainless steel over the cooktop hood. We got three burners right here with your knobs down here. Your tabletop cooktop drill ready to go.
Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh.
You can't have a tropical house without a big, bam, fire breathing.
Oh my God.
Look at that. Oh, it breathes fire and smoke. There you go. And it's on a motion detector.
Well, welcome to your living room.
That's kind of magic.
It's like a voodoo room.
We got a built-in bar over there. You can entertain guests in front of the fireplace.
I don't think you can top that.
Oh, my God.
This is the most bitchin' shower in Los Angeles County right here.
Shower heads everywhere.
Nice little curtain of rainwater.
I want to get in.
Flip this knob for
double heated vents that'll blow dry you through the wall of water.
You guys are nuts.
You have no idea.
Jesus Christ.
Holy This is cool. It's like a little lagoon.
It is cool.
The pool's a different color.
Oh my gosh, it is.
Painted it.
Oh, it looks so much better.
Oh, wow. Got a boat in my backyard.
Yeah. I love awesome. The black bottom pool. Beautiful. It looks like a lagoon.
Nice.
It's raining.
Oh, wow. Oh my God.
We are shocked. I'm very happy.
My head's swimming with all the things. I don't even feel like I'm in the same house anymore. I feel like I'm in someplace tropical. I just want to have a bunch of friends over and let them experience this.
It's
weird. Like going to Disneyland, you know? You got to show everybody, like, hey, come check this out. This is. We got a hurricane in the backyard.
Take a glass. All right.
Monster House.
Monster House.
Yeah. You guys busted your ass this week, and for that, you get rewarded. Are your prizes. Right here, you get a Makita 18-volt cordless combo kit, a Makita 10-inch dual-slide compound miter saw, an ESAB GT350 Deluxe cutting outfit.
Nice. Thank you.
Congratulations, good job.
Thanks, Monster House.
Good job.
Until next time, when who knows, the monster may be coming to your house.
I'm thinking about our sweet honeymoon, making love in a lovely lagoon, the sound of the waves, the tropical wish we could still be there. Tiki love, I can't stop dreaming about our tiki love. I'm coconut to buy.